What's up, guys? Welcome back to ABMTB. And as you all know, bike maintenance is a regular part of biking. So on this video, I'm going to be walking you guys through the steps that I took in order to clean my brakes. It's a good thing to note that I'm not a professional bike mechanic, so follow at your own risk. Some of the things that I'll be using is some regular household items such as sandpaper and some isopropyl alcohol, which in the end, I'm not even sure if it really helped. Let's get to it. Alright, so that was probably another 15 to 20 minutes of work, and although I feel things are going fairly well, I feel like it's painfully slow, so I might just skip to sanding them down a little bit, trying to get some more of the grease out. So going back in time here, as I said earlier, I'm not really too sure if the isopropyl alcohol really worked. I felt like every single time I was putting it on, my brakes were just getting into worse condition. So in the end, I just ended up sticking to sandpaper, which worked really well, made my brakes work really smooth, and got all the grease out. Alright, so I just finished cleaning one side of my rotor, and I have to say that this 2000 grit sandpaper really came in handy, and it easily did the best job between it and the isopropyl alcohol. Anyway, I'm gonna get to cleaning the other side, and let's skip to the time lapse. So once again, a really key thing to note here is that I am using 2000 grit sandpaper. Now, this sandpaper is fine enough to where I'm not going to deteriorate the state of my brakes, which is something that I definitely don't want to happen. Alright, so I went ahead and cleaned the other side, and right now I feel like my rotor is at a point where I could just slap it on my bike and the pads should do the rest of the work. However, because my pads are also contaminated, I'm going to go ahead and replace them as well. So, let's get to it. So, if you're going to be doing this for yourself, it'll definitely be a good idea to put on some gloves so that you don't contaminate your new pads. I am setting a very poor example as I'm not wearing them. However, I unfortunately did not have any clean gloves that day. And the way I contaminated my pads in the first place was, in fact, with dirty gloves. Alright, so I finally finished everything. Now it's just time to put the wheel back into the bike and everything's gonna be ready. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys next week. Peace!